Shooting. Wow. Hey, everyone, we got another letter, and it came from Jason and his request for us to produce something on how fish bite. So for you people on the YouTube, in this short, we're going to look at number 42, the whys and hows of salmon and the way that they will bite your bait behind a rotating flasher. Now, Cosmos, come on now. Give it up. Let's look into his right eye and learn why these flasher-fly combinations really do produce fish. What you're looking at is our Super Magnum Glow Flasher. Boat speed's 2.5 to 3 knots. The depth that it's being fished at is 80 feet. Trolled behind it is our Super Magnum Fly. This is a polar bear hair fly, hot pink in color, and coho prefer that shrimp, and that's the color it is, that hot pink. And we've caught some really nice fish with this combination. Now, here's some of the secrets to trolling a flasher of any size, whether it be big, small, double small. This is what the rules of thumbs are. If the flasher itself is 14 inches, you want 2.5 times the length. So approximately 30 inches of leader length on something of that size would be the best for you. 2.5 times the length's the standard. Wow, nothing better than getting a fish hooked up like this that you see here. These hooks go deep into the head, and that proves to me that this is really the best way to go. I prefer using 180 grit wet and dry sandpaper. I like to use a circle motion on my hooks, and I like them to be sticky sharp to the nail. Wow! That'll give you your best holding power. Also, a trick that I do, I've used it for years, is I bend the hook in a reversed manner. I first of all bend it over this direction. I then come up and I bend the tip upward, and then I like to bring it back in line with the eye of the shank so everything flows together clean. And when the fish comes to bite, as you see here, you see how it gets in right? This is so critical. And in our pink fly that you see on the screen there, this was the fly that we were using. And look at this, sticky sharp to the nail. Wow, how do you beat a combination like that? Now this flasher, if you want the flasher to spin a little bit faster, you want to flatten the nose. If you want a slower boat speed, but you want the flasher to continue to rotate, you need to bend the tail. And for you guys that use plastic flashers like the hot spots, hey, just stick them on the heater of your truck when you're going into the fishing grounds. Soften it up a little bit, and you'd be surprised. Just a little bit of movement can make a flasher super, super good and catch a lot of fish, or toss it away or keep trying. And that's why you see my lures are in a special box, because these are the lures that have won derbies and are productive. And there's nothing worse than getting a best friend out on the boat with you, giving him one of your best lures and watch him break off a big king because he hasn't had the experience of really what he was getting into. And experiences in life, I'll tell you, like for instance now, procrastination. If I have a problem, which I see here now I do with these knots and this leader, and if I don't fix this problem right away, what's going to happen is I might get a big fish on, lose my best flasher and one of my favorite lures because I procrastinated. That's not good. So here's your affirmation of life for you youngsters. Don't procrastinate on a problem. If you have a problem, you can focus on it, get some help, get some counseling. But take it head on and get it done right away. Don't let it start controlling you. Because the one thing that you have over anybody else is you have time. And time's on your side if you start handling it correctly. So problems, don't procrastinate and don't let them build. Take care of it now. And I'm going to fix these knots so when I do get that big fish, I'm going to catch one. So I'm going to clear the table now. I see, Cosmos, that you missed. He did. He missed. And he's standing there holding his stick. Crazy. Okay, my shot, isn't it? Okay. You always want to take time to chalk your tip of the stick. Come down, line yourself up. Now, you don't need a lot of speed here, but just a smooth stroke. Nice that worked. Again, chalk your stick, but don't chalk your stick over the table because the excess goes down on the cloth. And then you want to kick it a little bit with your hand to clean it up. 11 in the corner. Now on this shot, a little bit of backspin on the cue ball, but not a lot because it tends to let backspin on this object ball, which tends to jump out of the pocket. Now I got the 8 up at the corner there. So we're just going to take the 15 over here easy, off the rail nice. And now we have kind of a problem because I have the 4 ball in the way of the 8. Cosmos, 8 ball, corner pocket.